You're what's up, Brody? How you is a bow? Hope you're doing well. Hold on, let me go ahead and see how everything goes. Yeah, I'm good. All right, cool. Pop in, I'll catch you later, Brody. Appreciate it, man. Appreciate it, Zabo. Love you, man. Love you, fam. Yeah, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? And welcome. It's crashing way. So you might got no dick yet. You good, bro? You good? You good? It's crazy ways. It's crazy. What's going on, Cole? What's going on, everybody? Welcome in. It's your boy Llama Samba. We are getting ready. We got some good matches here tonight, y'all. We got the quarterfinals for King and Queen of the Ring for Insanity side. Then we'll get down to semifinals and finals next week. As we have Monday, it's going to be the semifinals for Turmoil. Thursday, semifinals for Insanity, and then the finals will be taking place right inside of King and Queen of the Ring, the Coliseum, on August 31st, next Saturday. So it is lit. We do got some great matches here. We also have the title for title for the Insanity Women's Television Championship and the Crash Course Women's Championship as Alicia faces Alexis, and both titles will be on the line. It will be a triple threat Insanity Television Championship match between Bruce Jackson, Ian, and the returning Musty Diglett. And in the main event, we have an impromptu women's championship match as Miss Blood will defend her title against T-Raw Dubs. It is about to be a fire show here tonight, and I cannot wait, you guys. We cannot waste no time. We're going to get right into the action. Starting off with the first match of the evening. Vega made their way through the first round. Advance, and now we'll be taking on Baby Zyla in the quarterfinal here tonight. So let's see who will walk out of here the victor. I'm picking my opponent at King of the Ring. You're gonna defend your United States Championship. It's gonna be you and Musty for the United States title. That's gonna be a fire match. Alright then, so we have another title match set up for King of the Ring. King and Queen of the Ring. It'll be Jester versus Musty Diglett for the United States title.
San Jose, California, the
right, let this match begin. Vega versus Baby Zyla. Quarterfinal match for Queen of the Ring. 15 minutes on the clock, and this matchup begins. Ooh, what a jawbreaker right to the face. Very unique offense. Now doing some damage there to the foot. Yo, Eric, appreciate the first, man. Welcome in. Welcome back home. How are you feeling, big dog? A new voice in front. Eric, how the fuck can I do your voice? Yo, what's going on, Mr. Boy Eric? You know what I'm saying?
What? Oh my
god. Why so difficult? Well, I could do that one, but what's going on, guys? What's going on, guys? Yeah, be good. Not yes, son. What is called? Uh-oh. Nope, sent right to the outside. Now Vega going up top rope. This man said, "Get some." Oh, that's why you said tacos. By the way, your mic low. Oh, maybe the fuck people gonna hear me. Let me check something real quick. My fault. Hear it? She was too short. Oh, my God. All right, if y'all can hear me well, let me know. Let me say chicken bars with tacos. Hear it? It's Taco Tuesday, so you know I gotta get my queso. It's me and my homies of SG, we grabbing them pesos. But you know I like my Doritos with my meat on it. Pause. Pause, bro. Never mind, I'm not doing great. I'm not doing great. I'm not doing great. This is hard. Hold on, Paul. God. Boo. I will gladly take a boo or anything, guys. Crossbody. I heard this taco freestyle. Don't do it. Don't do it. Please. I have to tell you, get out. What is this? What? Kick out that boy. Stomp right to the head. It was the biggest piece of dog shit I've ever heard. Oh, man. Alright, Vega with a good combination. It's the biggest piece of dog shit. Ooh! He's right on the outside now, Vega. Oh, kick right to the gut. Oh, counter. Another counter. At least it's a piece. Get out. Shut up, Eric. I'm so weak. Uh-oh. Vega. It's the drastic roundhouse kick. He's going for the pin. One. Two. Kick out of two. That's Vegas thinking right now. And baby diving away from the rope. Off the arm. Uh-oh. And the try to go for the KOV, the knee of victory, but it did not work. And a counter. But there it is, that patent guillotine from Vega. The world champion, the most stylish wrestler of all time. Over Kane is the best. Yo, DeJuan, I am so devil. I like how my freaking chat tried to say that you was a likely harasser. That's funny. Nah, I let him go. How do I do this? Kick out at two. Makes sense. I'm done. How do you even get this, though? And the drop kick. Using the rope. Now with the springboard. Try to go for the Hurricane Rana. But he's not able to move out the way. DT. Oh, counter. Oh. Stops and blocks are going crazy. Ooh, a huge punch. And Vega, can they nail it? F5. And going for the pin is this hit. One, two. Vega will move on to the semifinals. Step closer to queendom. Will it be possible? But it's one more match to figure out who Vega will face in the semifinals next week. Will it be her tag partner, Bree Bree? Or will it be one half of the new Insanity Women's Tag Team Champions, J Money? Actually, I might as well not even get rid of this theme because they use the same one. So let me go ahead and just remove that one and then get... There we go. If the male Vega goes to the pros and he goes to Infinity for absolute confusion, I will try my absolute hardest to trade him to Turmoil, because I ain't gonna lie, as much as I love it, I can't do the confusion. the Double Vega Mix Tag Power Hour. That is hilarious, Kage. Think of the rating. You and you, Cole, Jessa, and Davi always talking about ratings. That's hilarious. That would be true, though. Finally, back winning championships, just like we always knew she would. Jay Money now one half of the Insanity Women's Tag Team Champions. Jay Money, it is a battle of the arm bars because they both use that submission maneuver. 15 minutes on the clock and this matchup begins. Winner of this match will take on Vega in the semifinals. Right now, Bree be able to counter. Oh, elbow right to the face. And the flip. And the ground and pound. Ooh. And I'm doing some damage to that arm. Remember, it sets up perfectly for the arm bar. Oh, they're able to roll out of the way. Send Jay Money into the corner. Ooh, punch right to the face. And, ooh! These two are going to be damaged to each other's arms, like, brutally. They know how much this is on the line, then they will go the distance. Oh! Uh-oh. Bree. Piper's pit. That's a rope break. That's one of Venus's bones right there. What? Into the corner, going up the top rope. Uh-oh. Ooh, that looks kind of bad. Uh-oh, Jay Money, the first one to get the armbar cinched in. It's a rope break though. I'm done, bro. Top rope. Ooh. Going for the pin. One. Two. Kick out at two. Now roll up by Bree Bree. One. Two. And a kick out at two. And knee right to the head. There it is, doing some more damage to that arm. Now Bree Bree with a ground and pound attack. Oof. And now J Money. Piper's pit. Both use the Piper's pit as well. That's insane. One, two, kick out at two. Uh-oh. And there it is, the armbar. Cinched in, nowhere even near the ropes this time. And J Money picks up the win. Our semifinals for Insanity is set. Vega versus J Money next week. And whoever wins will go to King and Queen of the Ring to fight for the crown. All right, moving on. We now move on to our quarterfinal matches for King of the Ring. We have Spesh versus Jordan Armstrong. This is definitely about to be a hard-hitting match. We just hope that Spesh can use his side or his power to his advantage. I'm done, Co. Oh yeah, right, my fault. An audio trope we wish them and the best of luck on their future endeavor. I'll promise I'll get the person fired next time. Alright, Spesh versus Jordan Armstrong. Quarterfinal match, 15 minutes on the clock. And this match begins. Oh, trying to go for a crossbody, and Jordan Armstrong using that strength to push him off. Now, suplex. This is a mismatch for real. Already a two count, kick out by Spash. Uh-oh. Ooh, right to the back. Oh, ooh, leaping clothesline. Sent off the ropes. Flapjack. Doing some damage to the leg. Got those some punches. Send it to the corner. Oh my lord. Especially with the counter. Jordan Armstrong is too damn big. And oh, the arm drag. Especially trying to find some hope in there. Able to be countered though. Lifts him up. Drops him on the rope. Going for the pin this time. Kick out at one. Just finding that power again. Leaving clothesline. Suplex. And ain't no way in hell this 400 pound mug is climbing up the top rope and hit the axe handle right to the right. Oh. Gaining some momentum here. Shoots the leg and he is on fire. Now going for the pin. He got it too. Special able to counter. Pushes him back. Oh. And Special able to counter. Leg drop. Gives him back up. This time, Snake Eyes in the corner. And alley-oop. Stomps right through the hand. Especially able to get back up. Pushes him off. Ooh. Trick shot. One, two, kick out at two. And, bookend. What are you trying to do here? Slam dunk. One, two, and a kick out at two. Especially with a counter. And the knee right to the gut. We're still at that mug. Try to go for the crossbody. Armstrong pushes him off. Suplex. Punches right to the face. Another kick to the back. Special able to counter. Into the outside. Uses the ropes. Lifts him back up. Drops him on the barricade. Oh my god. Special able to counter though. Throws him back inside the ring. Gotta go for a big boot. Sends him to the outside. Oh, that's able to counter. Oh. Oh, there we go. STO. Oh my god, man. Count to five. I wouldn't blame Spech if he wanted to win this match by a counter. Don't taunt. He's right there. Ooh, throws him back on the rope. Back in the leg. Oh, able to counter. Clothesline. He's getting manhandled. He was for a second, but now Spech looks like he's gained that confidence back. Spine buster. There's the arm. Uh-oh. Jordan Armstrong able to counter. Spech able to counter. Off the ropes. Uses the knee. Leg drop. Armstrong able to get back up though. And slam dunk. Yeah, that was it. That was it. That might be it. One, two, and Armstrong advances. Yeah, it was completely mismatched from the get-go. Spech did try his best to give it his all, but Armstrong is just way too damn big. Let's see if Captain Daddy can get some vengeance here for Spech, and if he can move on to the semifinals to face Armstrong. So it'll be Captain Daddy versus Solo Drunk.
The following contest.
Yeah, you are whoever's on the freaking like music truck is fired. Let's say Captain Daddy, no Daddy. Here you go, what? All right, Captain Diddy versus Solo Drunk 1-on-1. 15 minutes on the clock. Matchup begins. Ooh, starting off here with a good combination. Ooh, combo strike. Captain. No, it's a cease and desist from the Zodiac. Why do I have a cease and desist from the Zodiac? Wait, who are they cease and desisting? What is going on? They're using their theme. Are you talking about MSK? The MSK theme? What are you talking? First off, that's so dope. Doesn't sound different enough. But first off, we are very completely different shows. I think if they were in the pro leagues, then yeah, I would change the theme. But people see things differently or hear things differently. Oh, counter. Ooh! Give this to him after his match. I'm not giving him a cease and desist. Fine, I'll change his name next week. One, two, and a kick out of two. Yeah, that was a crazy Canadian. Stroll Drunk has been on fire on the offensive end in this match. And then it was countered immediately. Close line. Military press. Followed by a splash on the back. Going for a pin. Kick out at two. Well, he got him up. Captain Daddy showing off the strength right into a military press. Go for a pin again. One, two, kick out at two. And a roll up. One, two, one count. A knee right to the face. DDT. Ooh, and a look for a knee strike. Sends it to the corner. Uh-oh, Solo Drunk said no. Can he land it? Cardiac kick. One, two. Kick out of two. Ooh, standing corkscrew moonsault. Now going up. The top rope. Top rope for a frog splash. It was countered. Now throwing the blow. They're going back and forth right now. And now they have a stalemate, and they are trading punches back and forth. Scoop slam. Solo Drunk gets back up. Sent right into the corner. And setting up for it once again. If he lands it, it may be over. Cardiac kick right to the back of the head. The Solo Drunk have it. Is he going to advance? One, two, and a kick out at two. Captain Eddie is staying strong. Can he stay in it? Off the ropes. Hurricanrana. Try to go for elbow drop. It was countered. Now off the ropes. Clothesline. God dang. And now Eddie with a splash on the back. Going for the pin. One, two. Kick out at two. I know he will. Don't pin him like that. That would be mad disrespectful. And he has one more in the tank. Hits the splash. One, two, three, and Eddie takes the win. In the semifinals next week on Insanity, Captain Eddie versus Jordan Armstrong. Whatever, Carl. I'll change the theme next week, guys. Don't we? And now it is time, ladies and gentlemen. This is the match that we've all been waiting for. It is a champion versus champion match for both the Crash Course Women's Championship and the Insanity Women's Television Championship between Alicia and Alexis. He's walking out with both titles.
The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the International Classic Wrestling Women's Television and Internet Classic Wrestling All-Star Women's Championships.
We're not doing this again. I have been using this for since I started. We're not doing this again, Cole. And it's not going to be another cease and desist. It's not. What is it? A drink, nigga. I'm so weak. All right, I'll take up upon that alpha. Thank you, Coalition. I appreciate it. Hot out here. Impressive. two titles on the line here in this match. The Sandy Women's Television Championship. And the Crash Course Women's Championship.
Introducing first, from Baltimore, Maryland, the Internet's Classic Wrestling All-Star Women's Champion, Mrs. Ann O'Kee! And her opponent, from New York, the International Classic Wrestling Women's Television Champion, the Queen, Alexa!
You see our referee, Adrian Burner, right here, grabbing both titles, the Women's Television Championship and the Crash Course Women's Championship. Both very highly working titles. So who will walk out of here with both titles at hand? Will it be Alexis or will it be Miss Alicia O'Keefe? 15 minutes on the clock and this matchup begins. Right in the corner and able counter. Now this matchup came about at Crashing Waves. We saw two teams collide, which would be Miss Cash in the Case, Jessica Jackson, and then Sandy Women's Television Champion Alexis taking on Crash Course Women's Champion Alicia O'Keefe and Kurama. The entire team action, it was absolutely crazy, and it went down to the last minute both teams had pinfalls at the exact same time, and the ref counted Alexis instead. So this match came to be. Alexis now on the offense. Kick out. And stand up. Both miss. Oh, elbow once again. Clitor from Power Rangers. I have a feeling I know who that is, but that low-key does sound... Wait a minute. Yo! Actually, I do remember this. That's actually pretty sick. But we was going for more of the Shigo vibe. Yeah, I was gonna say, it was more like Shigo. Counter thrown to the outside. And remember, champion's advantage for both is lose by disqualification or countout. They both keep their titles. If they both are in a draw, they both keep their titles. What happened there? Alexis throws Alicia back inside the ring. Alexis now getting chased. Oh, slap across the face. Right into the natural selection. This match brings what that trick to a whole different level. I am done, Kage. And a kick out at two. Able to roll out of the way. Uh-oh. And we've seen this before. KOD! And going for the pin. 1, 2. Kick out at 2. And now going up top rope. And an elbow drop. Back up on the feet. And sent right into the ref. strong Uranagi. And knee right to the back. Stomp on the arm. Doing some damage to the leg. And you know Alexis' signature submission is that figure eight leg lock. And this McKee's able to counter. And he's got her up there. And doing a couple of squats as well. Followed by a suplex. Ooh. Standing moonsault. And now going up top rope. Crossbody. Not able to kick back up. Off the ropes. Try to go for a move, and this McKee's able to counter. And uh-oh. Try to go for the glam slam, and it was countered immediately. Oh, another counter. And oh my God, this might be it. Second KOD. One, two, kick out. Oh Lord, the perfect setup into that KOD was insane. Now looking up. Ooh. Okay, KOD stands for Kiss of Death. Basically Bianca's finisher. Ooh. Shut up, Rick. I hate you. What's about to happen here? What is... Ooh! No, that one is me on the saddle. Oh, thank God. Flash. And going for the pin. Is that it? One. Two. And a kick out of two. Almost close. Almost close. Punches. There's another flash. Now Alexis rolling out to the outside, trying to hold on to the ropes. Alexis able to counter.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
Not you. And a spear into the corner. Alexis with a stomp right to the chest. Knee right to the face. Uh-oh. Setting up for something here. And it's countered! Going for the pin. One, two, and a kick out of two. Oh my, so close. So many close chances. What is Alicia going to do? Alicia setting up for something. You just John Cena, are you sure about that, Yulama? That was hilarious. Uh-oh. Set up. Glam slam! And almost tried to go for the KOD! And it's countered by Alexis. Now Alexis on the ropes. Stomp right to the chest. On the outside. There's a punch. There's another one. Using the ropes as leverage and sent to the outside. One, Alexis has to realize that she won't win the Asia's title if won by countout. Now going up to the top rope. Crossbody. These two are going the distance. It could be anyone's game here in this matchup. Sent back in the sent back inside the ring. Something. Now taunting to Alicia. She has this moment. And Alexis, we knew that she was going to go for this sooner or later. That figure four is set up. And now it's about to be bridged. Figure eight is locked in. Let's go of it. But why? And the lariat. One, two, and Alexis is double champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your and queen, Alexa.
That had to be one of the greatest matches I have ever seen for either title. It was indeed probably the best setup ever in this match. It was great. That was a great match. I give him that one. That was really great. All right. The eight woman battle royal. We all know what happens in these types of battle royals. It is a number one contenders match. So, winner of this battle royal has the chance to fight for the Insanity Women's Championship at the next premium live event, not the one coming up. Because, obviously, that is defended it at Crash and Waves and defending it tonight. So, might have to wait for a while. But who will be the next contender? That is a question amongst many that we don't probably even know the answer to until we realize it now. So give me 1 second. Send this up. Boom. Boom. All right, everybody. Yeah, I'm good. All right, cool. Let's go. Well, we know who Coalition's going for. You already said this, Cole. Welcome in. Hey, we got Taco Bell ALW. Double steak quesadilla with sour cream and tomato. Man, now you wouldn't leave me one type of bill, but trying to cut back on that stuff, man. True, that's understandable. I usually have the breakfast quesadillas from Taco Bell. Those kind of slap. Hello, this is my Twitch mother, Chief Vibe. Nah, I'm in love. Hey, yo. Thank you.
It's Chelsea.
Battle Royal number one contenders match. Who is going to be the next contender for the Insanity Women's Championship? And this A1 Battle Royal will begin. In this match, we have Darth Cater, Kurama, Darryl Bobera, Stale, KY Valkyrie, Nine, Celeste, and Chief Vibe. Stale trying to eliminate KY already off rip. Valkyrie able to fight it off. Ooh. Alright, trying to eliminate Darth Cater. Open palm strike. And oh my god, already! First elimination is Darth Cater. Outside. Oh, man, that's just started. We already got an elimination. That is for you. That one is out the, that one is out the gate. Well, now it's time to eliminate Vine. Uh-oh. Yo, hold on, what is that emote? Anarchy. Oh, that is funny. Not the chair. Ooh. Wait, how did... Wait. Okay, he's back in the ring. I was going to say, how is he walking outside the ring on the apron? Yeah, that was personal. Jesus. Oh my... And that is also personal. That's a very painful maneuver. And it looks like Kurama delivering a taxia. Taxi set. Oh my God, that spear. Elias is saving himself from elimination once again. And Dara is eliminated. Down the six. Dell has been holding on for those works for a good while. Ooh. Oh, counter. You two are counting each other's time. Eliminate one another. And Celeste has been eliminated. Down to five. Oh, counter. Ooh. Now going for eliminations on one side of each corner. And KY Valkyrie is eliminated. Final four. Eliminated. When the submission is locked in, there's an extra strategy to wear down the opponent so that way you can eliminate them easily. How is mine just staring at Chris? What is going on right now? Oh my Lord. And now Karen is trying to eliminate nine. Saves herself from elimination. Ooh. My God, the headbutt. Oh, Stella saves herself from elimination. Thank you. And Kurama has been eliminated. Down to the final three. And Stale stood strong, but is eliminated. Down to the final two, 9 and 5. The Wins will earn themselves an opportunity once again at the Insanity Women's Championship. Both have earned opportunities before. Both have failed at those attempts. But they can have a second chance of redemption. And Nine going for the anchor on Vibe. And Vibe able to break out of it though. Oh my lord. And Nine doing everything. I'm done, Cole. How is this even the hardest debate for you? Ooh. They're both giving it their all right now in this match. And it can end either way. They're both just countering one another. Now in the corner. And save. They are both fighting to save themselves from elimination. Dropped in the corner. Make it a triple threat. Denied. And now Nine setting up for something fierce. And oh, it was blocked. What do you mean denied? Denied. Moonlight drive. And the disarm her. And Nine is tapping, but that is not how we're supposed to win this match. Uh-oh. We're getting on for dear life. And it is over. Vibe has won another chance at this title.
Here is your winner, Castle of Pain.
Yeah, what's up, Dobby? Welcome in. How you with it, fam? Road to redemption starts here. I've been better. You good, bro? Is everything all right? All right, moving on to this triple. All right, Cole. Moving on is a triple threat Extreme Rules match for the Insanity Television Championship. Bruce Jackson is not one now, but two competitors. One being the great returning Musty Diglett. Then we have Ian, the All-American, these two definitely probably are not going to separate from their rivalry. And Bruce Jackson, who is about to die, as I would say. You explain it. All right, bet, bro, I got you. I'll make sure I pop in there. But all right, it is go time, ladies and gentlemen. Who will walk out of here with the Insanity Television Championship? Will it be the Diglett? Will it be the All-American? Or will it be the Lady Destroyer?
The following contest is a triple threat.
actually dig it. There it is, ladies and gentlemen, the Insanity Television Championship on the line in its first ever triple threat match. Right, Mr. Diglett, the All-American, Lady Destroyer. Triple threat match, no time limit, and this matchup begins. Oh. Oh. counter. Try to go for a German suplex. That didn't work. Oh, knees right to the back. Backstabber. Oh, counter. Oh, knee right to the back. Take him down. Oh, counter. German suplex. Now has a kendo stick. Down the stretch. Able to break free. Throws the kendo stick. Alright, lift him up. Let's see if he's trying to drop him on the rope for a musty was, but it did not work. Knees right to the face. Turnbuckle and throws him like a rag doll. He tried to pick up the kendo stick, he uses his own, that didn't work. Over the counter. Another gator roll. Ooh. Kick right to the back of the head. DDT. Ooh, exploder. And you right to the chest. Right to the pin. Kick out. Ooh. And you right to the gut. Suplex. Send the range of the corner. Now Ian has the upper hand. What is he thinking right now? A big stomp right to the chest of Bruce Jackson. Uh-oh. Package powerbomb. They're right in the corner. And oh, the suplex. Now going for the pin. Ian able to break it up. Oh, sounds like the Bruce Jackson's face. And is it going to hit him? And slam him on the apron. And Ian follows the fan's command, or follows the ICW Galaxy command, and pulls out the table. And Bruce Jackson using the poison mist. Oh. Exploder from Musty. Ooh. Oh, the Kinshasa from the middle rope. Now Ian gonna take advantage to steal this win. Bruce Jackson able to break it up. Back three on the rope. Oh, kick right to the face. Had to use the knee, it was countered. Ooh, another counter. Could be anyone's game here in this matchup. Uh-oh. And try to go for Kinshasa, did not work. DDT, going for the pin. And almost had it kick out at two. But there it is, that patent ankle lock of Ian. And Bruce Jackson was able to break it. What's up, Ian? Ooh, Michinoku driver. Going for the pin on Musty though. One, two, and kick out at two. Counter. Ooh. Ooh, able to hit Ian. This might be it. Kick out at two. Nice kick. You got the sledgehammer. Now Ian with a sweeper hold on Bruce Jackson. Bruce Jackson able to roll him up though. Musty Diggler breaks up the pin. Going for the pin. Ian breaks it up. Backstabber. Northern Lights. Ooh, suplex onto the chair. There's a trash can in there. Drops him on the turnbuckle. Bruce Jackson throws the chair at Musty. Let's be able to get back up there and clothesline. And Ian with that patent ankle lock once again. Bruce Jackson able to break it up though. Using the ropes as leverage. Inverted DDT. Oh my God. And that's a beautiful German suplex. And Kinshasa That might be it. Bruce Jackson might retain here. And he does. Jackson is a sneaky one, man. He's always giving it his hardest somehow. This is unreal. Unbelievable. But all right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the main event. We've all been waiting for this. Ms. Blood will defend her title in this main event match for the Sandy Women's Championship against T-Raw Dubs.
Is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the Internet Classic Wrestling Women's Championship.
Sanity Women's Championship. A lot of history behind this belt.
Introducing the challenger from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, T-Rex Dub. And her opponent from Edinburgh, Scotland, the Internet's Classic Wrestling Women's Champion, H.J.
Sanity Women's Championship on the line here tonight. No time limit. These guys can go for a while. This matchup begins. Starts off with a bat with a mad clothesline. Able to counter. Got to use the springboard. He's going to go for it this time. Tornado DDT. Into the corner. counter by T-Raw. Combination of strikes. Ooh, my lord. Beautiful slam. Counter by Miss Blood. Drop kick right to the face. Sent right to the outside. Oh, counter. Brush of leg sweep right into a submission hold. And there's a little bit of fight out of the hole. Springboard, tornado DDT. Ref John Cone is getting in the goddamn way. Countered by Miss Blood. Then right into the turnbuckles. Oh, counter. Try to go for a combination of strikes. Able to stop it midway in. Springboard, Frankensteiner. And Miss Blood has something locked in. Could not reach. That was probably a good cover up. Now going up top rope. Ooh, caught midway in. Power bomb by T.I. Counter. Super kick right to the face. Tornado DDT on the outside. And Miss Blood with the cross face on the outside. She does this before. Had done it to Vibe last Saturday at Crashing Waves. These two were putting on a hell of a show in that match. And now Miss Blood ready to do this mug again. This time with T-Raw. T-Raw now. Top of trash. Uh-oh. Ooh, counter. Try to go for a move. Miss Blood able to counter it. Ooh, kick right to the leg. I go for a springboard. Miss Blood stops it. Neck breaker. Now trying to drag T-Raw away from the ropes. Thinking about here. Oh, try to go for that cross face once more. Raw, Northland Lights. German suplex going for the pin. Kick out at one. Clothesline sent to the outside. Make sure they go inside the ring. And the Haluva kick. Is T-Raw the new women's champion? Going for the pin. One, two, rope break. Smart strategy by Miss Blood. Learned a lot from Jester, but oh my god, those punches. Uh-oh. Koji clutch locked in. Miss Blood able to break out of the hole. And a beautiful maneuver. And the elbow drop. And now T-Raw climbing into the corner. Drop kick to the back. Able to counter. Off the ropes. German suplex. Miss Blood able to counter. Ooh. Going for the pin. One. Two. Kick out at two. Almost retained. Start to the arm. Now trying to drag away from the ropes. Arm drag. stomp right to the leg. Now this leg going up top rope. What's the Kenshi thinking here? I think he is getting up really fast. Counter. Springboard. Tornado DDT. And the purple Thunder Bomb. Oh, right into the ref. Standing Aluva kick. Now going for the pin once more. Right down the ropes. One, two. Rope break again. This blood is using that ring awareness to a T. Able to counter. Punch right to the face. Now Fira trying to roll over. But she's about to roll outside the ring. Oh, countered. On the rope. Now using the ropes as leverage. German suplex. Basement drop kick. Miss Blood rolls out to the outside. Hope she can recuperate and recover. Ooh! And able to counter. And right into the announce table somehow. Hurricanrana. What's Blood thinking about here? He's gonna go for the cross face, but outside the ring again. It is this type of pain that, yes, that just elevates this to a whole nother level. But this is definitely taking it way too personal. Gotta do it inside the ring. But this again, super kick to the face. Over the counter. Now I want to hurry up and get back inside the ring. Count that eight. Both made it back inside. Going for the pin. One, two. T-Raw picks up the win. Is the new champion. No freaking way. It's not tonight. It can't be tonight. Jessica Jackson! Jessica Jackson, she's cashing in. She's cashing in, cashing the case. We have an impromptu championship match. After T-Raw just picked up the win and became the new women's champion, Jessica Jackson took the moment, took advantage, and now literally a tired out T-Raw could lose this title. And oh no, the Halupa kick. This could be, no, this can't be. One, two, kick out at two. T-Raw cannot believe that this is just happening right now. Jessica probably befuddled at the fact that Miss Blood just lost her title to T-Raw here tonight. Nope. Ooh! And rolled out to the outside. Ooh, dropped on the apron. Uh-oh, counter. Taking out the leg. I tried to go for Koji Clutch. I know that she was going to go for it. Countered. And Jessica Jackson throws T-Law back inside the ring. There's a little bit of trash talking to the announce table. I don't know what I did, but okay. Make your moment. Make your moment. Clothesline. It's still crazy how T-Law is still fighting through this right now. And oh! And the Koji clutch applied. But Jessica Jackson able to break free out of the hold. And uh-oh, this may be the moment. Placing its mark, and T-Ra able to counter. She's trying to keep the championship. One, two, three, and Jessica Jackson's champion. Setting the time perfectly. Jessica Jackson cashes in, and we have a new Insanity Women's Champion. Only time will tell, Jessica. That is all I can say, but unbelievable ending. Unbelievable ending to this match. That is awesome. Like, congratulations. We had an impromptu women's champion until the cash. That is wild. I think that Jessica Jackson is now the second successful cash in of ICW. I'll give it that. That was a good show. That was a great show. I enjoyed the show entirely. We now have a lot to build upon next week and probably King and Queen of the Ring. But that was a sick ending. I cannot wait to see what's going to break down. But ladies and gentlemen, that was Thursday Night Insanity, and it's going to be a lot cooler next week when we figure out who's going to be in the finals, who's going to be at the show, who's going to be defending what title. It is just only going to get better by then. But ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate you guys for coming in, showing love, always doing what you guys are doing best. And it's only up from here. It's only going to be figuring out what's going to be going on, but I'm definitely going to be excited. I'm definitely going to be lit. And you already know the whole Four Horsemen is definitely going to be there for that night to crown our two King and Queen of ICW. So until then, guys, let's see who we are going to read out to. Oh, yeah. Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you all have a great rest of your night, and I will see everyone later. Probably tomorrow. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Llama Sama out. Deuces. Ooses. All right. Alexa, disconnect device.
Now disconnected from Galaxy X.